Hi, welcome back to Rebecca's Travels. Today we're going to be talking about the country Malta, so let's jump right into it. Malta's airport is called Liqua Airport, and it's located towards the south of Malta. It's not a very large airport because obviously the island itself isn't very large. The island itself, Malta and Gozo and Camino, are not very green islands at all, so there's not a lot of greenery. More like a desert island. There are places to explore on Malta and Gozo, and the small Camino island, teeny Camino island, with I think just a few residents and maybe just one hotel. There's the Blue Grotto Caves down the south and the Dingley Cliffs down the south of Malta. There's also a lagoon in between Malta and Gozo and Camino. You can get a ferry to go from Malta to Gozo, and if you are looking for sandy beaches, then they are very hard to find. I stayed in St. Paul's Bay, which to be fair did not have a beach. It was next to the town of Jeeba. Jeeba has some shops and bars and restaurants. It also has a fair. But again, it's St. Paul's Bay is not a very lively resort. St. Paul's Bay has some shops, but wherever you go in Malta, you can find churches, cathedrals. There's also in Valletta, which is the capital of Malta, the Grand Harbour, so it's like a huge harbour, and that's nice to look at and visit. The liveliest place in Malta is Paisville, which is located between St. George's Resort and St. Julian's. And that's where all the nightclubs and bars are, lively bars. Again, other towns such as Medina and Mostar, again, are quite quiet, again with churches and parks. You can also get water sports on the island at St. Julian's Bay. There's also Golden Bay and Paradise Bay and Gahanja Bay. They are the sandy beaches in Malta. Going over to Gozo, Victoria is the capital city in Gozo. Again, it has lots of museums, churches, and a cathedral. And again, it's a nice place, but again, it's like very, very old because the islands are very, very old anyway. The Maltese currency is the lira, or it was a lira before it's moved into the euro. Because Malta has moved into the European Union, but it was previously the Maltese lira. And you can get buses to go to different towns. You can, the car hire is cheap. We have the car hire for 7 days. And you can take your car over on the ferry to Gozo. You can get hotels and apartments. Again, lots of supermarkets and shops dotted around the place. There's also Popeye Village as well, even though we didn't get to go to that, but I know that that's there at the time. It's a nice place. Apart from Julian's or like Paisville area, that's someone that's looking for a quiet holiday. Or in some cases, not looking for a beach or a sandy beach. But again, those that are looking for a sandy beach will probably have to go to resorts like Golden Bay and Paradise Bay and Garanja Bay. But again, if you're looking for a lively resort with plenty of entertainment, then again, St. Julian's, Georges Bay, again, is near at Paisville, so those would be the best places if you want to go and see any concerts or looking for a lively time. Or you could probably get a taxi from one of the other places to there. But yes, that basically it sums up Malta really. Again, there's lots of choice of hotels and apartments and like hostels, so and it's not too expensive to go there either, and that's another plus point. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next travel video. Thank you. Bye.